Is there any difference between Parvatasana and Adhomukha Svanasana, which is called mountain posture, and downward facing dog? So there are a lot of doubts about these asanas and a lot of questions. So if you don't know about it, let's find out together. Hi everyone, this is Neha. Before we start understanding more about these asanas, please subscribe the channel and click a bell icon right next to it. Also, you can follow me on Instagram with the ID of Yoga for Cure. So let's get started. There is a difference between Parvatasana and Adhomukha Svanasana. So Parvatasana is a mountain posture which looks like a mountain. For example, something like this. More stable, strong and ground towards earth. And when you talk about Adhomukha Svanasana, it's just a dog stretching its spine, something like this. So let's try and experiment by ourselves while practicing with the mat. Now, come to a full plank. Keep your both the hands apart from each other and legs straight. Okay, legs together, closer to each other. Now, from here, pushing your hip up, inhale, drop your heels down. This is more stable. Now you can see your ears and your arms are in straight line and your knee is straight line. It is actually looks like an A. Correct? You can feel a good stretch in your lower body than your upper body. From here, you can come to Parvat full plank again. From here, you can get into different asana without changing your foot, like Ashva Sanchalan. But the distance is going to be the same. Okay, now let us see what is the difference between this and Adhomukha Svanasana. Here, we're going to keep our foot apart from each other, slightly apart. And the more you go down, you're going to stretch your spine as if you're trying to reach the floor. You can see the difference here. So your ears are not aligned with your arms. All you want to do is like stretch your spine and reach the floor. If you want to experience this into deeper, you can also bend your knee a little. Only if you're not able to stretch your spine, you can see. If you're feeling better, if you can go down without bending your knee, try here. So you just saw the difference between two asanas, right? Again, in lot of different ways of yoga, you can see the same Parvatasana is done in a different ways. For example, sitting in Vajrasana, lifting your both the hands up straight. Not only Parvatasana, if you talk about Surya Namaskara, in different schools of yoga, they practice different ways of Surya Namaskara. Some practice 12 counts and some practice 10. Personally, I practice 10 steps of Surya Namaskara, if you have seen my previous video. So it's not a question of being somebody right or wrong. It's about you being comfortable what you're practicing. If you think you're connected to this set of practice and you feel comfortable with that, that goes amazing. Because yoga is very personal. It is not very commercial, or it is not somebody where you have to adopt. She is practicing, so I need to practice like that. Take it out from your mind. Whatever you feel good about it, that is amazing for you. The reason for me to make this video, because one of my video had lot of comments about this asana, people asking whether it's a downward facing dog or a mountain posture or what it is. So I've decided to make a video on it with a clarification. Alright, so if you have any asana like this in your mind, where you want to understand any asana or difference between them, then please drop it in a comment box. We'll be happy to, you know, come with the videos on that. There are times I don't answer few of the comments, that's because of, you know, lack of time and things. But definitely I go through all the comments and try to, you know, reply all of them. Thank you so much, and please write in a comment what do you feel about it.